Hey, welcome to the show. It's not going to be creative at all.
All right. Sorry. We're good. Anyway, so what is this? So I'm going to do something a little different today. Basically, a little bit of an unboxing. So throughout my time collecting comic books, hold on a second. Throughout my time collecting comic books, I've come across some pretty amazing stuff. And recently, I've decided to get them graded. I went to CGC, which is a company that does gradings. The problem I have with CGC is they are not very clear about their pricing, which is unfortunate, let's say the least. So basically what they would do is say, hey, this is how much a book is. If it's under $1,000, we're going to charge you this price. If it's over $1,000, we're going to charge you a separate price based on 4%, which I understand. The problem becomes when I say a book I believe is going to be $1,000, and they look at it and they say, no, buddy, that book's going to be a 9.2 instead of a 7 like you thought. They charge you based on fair market value. So basically, if I'm saying it's $1,000 because I think it's a 7.5, and they say, well, it's actually 9.4, and a 9.4 is $9,000 book, we're going to charge you based on that. So it's kind of like a, not a little shenanigans going on, but a little market manipulation, market thumb on the pressure, but that I'll probably voice over and do again because I'm too drunk to explain it right now. But anyway, I'm going to do a little unboxing. So the books I have are all, I think, first of all, some of them are from my childhood and I had to get them because I had to freaking get them. But it's only like, what, 10 books maybe? And, sorry. Oops, sorry. Oop, there we go. So, just gonna pop some open, see what we got, and we'll talk about it a little bit, I think. So the first book I'm gonna pull out is whatever the heck this is. So I'm gonna take this packing slip out before anyone sees my address. And alright, now I know what it is. I don't know what it's rated at. But Ninja Turtles third print number one. And all these books I got from local shops. I'll shout them out, Fat Jack's Brave New Worlds. And there's another one from a convention I went to in Jersey. Don't know the shop, sorry, shop person. But this is the book from, I'm not gonna say where it's from. Let me lower this light. Hold on. Stand by. A lot of glare here. Nah, can't do it that way. Nah, I got the other camera there. So this is a nice Ninja Turtles one. Came back at 7.5. Little disappointing on that grading. That kind of stinks. Okay, I could see some, I don't know if you could see it here. There's some bending on the corner here and up here. Yep, you can see it right there. That little boop boop. So I see that, and that makes sense. A little nick on this side here. So I kind of get it. A couple dimples. Let's see if I could get these dimples right here. Yep, That one right there. So a little small stuff for 7.5. That's pretty rough. A couple more, another little dimple you can see right here with the shine. So got to look at the greater, some smudging. All right. Oops. Again, everyone nauseous. A couple smudging down here. So I am not sure why a 7.5. I think that's a little harsh, but that, you know, third print, first Teenage Mutant Turtles, which is a book I always wanted to have. I think the first print is a little outside my price range. Maybe I'll trade up one day. It'd be nice to trade up one day, but the difference in value is a lot. Let's put it at a lot. So that is the first book I'm going to open. Sorry. Let me get all this out of the way. And second book. Oh, I know what this is already. I'm gonna leave this as a I'm gonna leave this as the last book. Sorry. I'm gonna leave that as the last one. Only because that's gonna be show my address. That's only because it's gonna be one of those books that is gonna be the, oh wow, he's got this? I'm gonna say, yeah, I do. Thanks to my buddy at, and people are gonna be like, oh, I love that place. I'm gonna say, yeah, that place is amazing. But I'm not gonna say the name of the place because I'm not going to do promotions. I'm just going to say again, there's two places I got these books from, and you know what, you gotta go to those places. If you want to find these books, you gotta go there. I'm not going to tell you where it is. You're going to have to shop around with my buddies. So this is another, I think I know what this is. Let me open all the packaging. Let's take this away. I'm not even going to look at the packing slip because I'm pretty sure this is, let's say, Wizard Comics. So back in the day, the reason why I bought this is because A, it's Wizard Comics. If you were born in the late 80s or early 90s, you know that Wizard. And that was like, if you want to get how much your book was worth, it was an Overstreet or online. Because guess what? Online didn't exist back then. It was Wizard World, and Wizard World had articles and everything, and it was actually a really, really interesting book. They had interviews, all that good stuff, and then they also printed out how much some of these books were worth, on what gradient, who knows, but yeah, it was just it was fun, and one of the first author that did with it, Wizard, was first artist that did the cover of Wizard was none other than Todd McFarlane, who did his Spider-Man cover. So Wizard had this thing where you do your artist, you have your artist, you do your drawing, and they always used to wear a Wizard hat, and Todd did a number of them, and this is the first one he did. And let's see what we got here. Pretty sure this is it. If it's wrong, then I lied. Yep, nope, it's Wizard. Definitely Wizard. Oh wow. Alright. 9.4. Okay. That's very respectable. So this is the cover. This brings back so many memories. First Wizard price guide, Todd McFarlane. Wow. 9.4. I'm happy about this. This that's nice. It's funny because making everyone nauseous. It's funny because this was one of those books that, you know, if you were collecting back in the day, you probably bought, but you beat the heck out of, because you open it all the time to see, you know, how much everything you had was worth and what's that. And this is 1991. So before the really, really, really big hype of that awkward mid to late 90s where everybody had a book and everybody's book was number one, and you had a lot of image books that were printing out millions and millions of copies and kind of destroying the industry. But that's another story. That's another story with Brendan. I think Brendan would be good to describe that whole situation of the 90s. And how, not saying it cheapened the way comics were thought of, but it kind of, it didn't do any favors. It really didn't. But moving on to other 90s books. Sorry if I'm making too much noise, but I got a lot of stuff going on here. Alright. Oh, wait. One of these aren't 90s. I think only one isn't 90s. I think the rest are. But not sure which one we're going to pull out first. So, you know. Let's see. Oh, they're all kind of... There's one big rubber band. Sorry, hold on. Hold on. I got this. I can figure this out. So anyway. Let's see if we could do a slow reveal. Hold on. Let's see. Can we read that? Nope. Wait. Get one underneath. Oh, hold on. We got a... What is this? Batman Ventures 12. I'm going to put the rest down. And I'll pull out the first one. This is Batman Ventures 12. This is the first Harley Quinn. And I have not looked at it yet. So I bought this at a convention in Jersey. I usually don't buy books from conventions unless I know the person that is selling them. I got burnt once on a convention book. It was the first Moon Knight, Werewolf by Night 32, and it looked gorgeous. And I have it over there, and I would pull it out, but it's going to cause too much of a delay. You know what? Let me pull it out. Hold on. Back. All right, so kind of get burnt on this. I'm gonna cover up the grading, but this is the book. So it looks gorgeous, right? Let me show the back real quick. Now if you're looking at the back, kind of see a problem. That's the most obvious problem right here, this section here, and maybe a little staining down here. They gave it a whopping 3.5, and the reason why they gave this a 3.5 is because they felt there was too much staining, which, you know, that label being ripped off and everything, okay, I get that. But other than that, like, this cover, paid $900 for it. And this was before Moon Knight came out with the TV show. Kind of butthurt about it. Kind of upset. What are you going to do? But this is why usually I don't buy from, as horrible as it sounds, I don't buy from conventions. And the reason why I don't buy from conventions is because, not that it's a high pressure sale, but it's generally kind of a high pressure sale. You have a guy that's, or person that's trying to sell a book. They grade it. They give you a discount. You think that discount sounds amazing. Instead of like sitting down and looking through the book and make sure everything's good, because it's not somebody you know, i.e. Fat Jacks, Brave New Worlds, or any of the local shops I usually buy my books from. Those are the two I'm going to mention again, because that's where these books come from. but you don't really take the time to sit down and look through them. I didn't take the time to look through that one. I kind of got burnt. $900. Now, after the show and everything, it's more of an acceptable buy. But this was long before the show. Moon Knight was still one of my favorite Marvel characters. The Broken Batman is, I love. So anyway, this book I got from another show, like I said, in Jersey, and it's Newsstand. And if you know me, I love Newsstand. I love the fact that CGC finally has decided to say, you know what, we're going to put Newsstand in its own category. We're going to make it known that these are Newsstand. Newsstand, especially in the late 80s, early 90s till today, newsstands are not easy to come by in the sense that they used to be sold at, newsstands, places that weren't comic book companies, that weren't shops that bought bulk. They would buy a couple books, and if they didn't sell on the news rack, they'd turn around, went back to DC or Marvel and said, hey, we didn't sell these, and they would be reimbursed a percentage of their losses. Basically, they put money up front, they couldn't sell it, the comic book company would say, all right, you didn't sell it, here's your money back in one form or another. So generally, you don't get a lot of these. Shouldn't say that. Usually they're well-worn and well-loved and well-read because, back in the day, it wasn't a collector's game. You would get the ones that are saved by people that kind of expected prices to go up. They expected, I had a Spider-Man 1 and it's now 10 times worth what I bought. Which you're always going to get, but they weren't saved and cared for in the same way that a shop that can't do anything with it and just decided, you know what, put it in the basement, we'll open that box in 20 years and see what happens. So, this is a Batman Adventures, number 12, came back at 9. I have not read the grader's notes, so I don't know. It does say Newsstand. Thank you. It's the first appearance of Harley Quinn. That's the Newsstand symbol for DC back in the 90s. Usually a barcode, like an actual barcode, is your indicator that's a Newsstand, unless it's prior to 1980, probably 1982 and before. They usually have a barcode. It may be like yellow colored in or have a line through it. Those are different. But current ones, 2000, maybe 6, and until today, they have the barcode, but it'll say direct edition. So you see some that had the barcode, and on the side it'll say direct edition or Newsstand, depending on the company. That's weird. What is that? Well, I've never seen that. A little odd circle. Oh, it's a little, okay. I guess CGC is doing something else to protect their IP as far as the covers and everything go. Which the reason why I go with CGC is not only because they're supposed to be quote unquote well respected, but also because their casing and their labels I think are far more attractive. Like that top is just, it's easy to read, you know what you're getting. And I like holographics. It's good. But yeah, this came back nice. I'm happy about that. That's a nine at a comic book convention. I am psyched about that, actually. I was not expecting that in the slightest. Alright, what's the next one? Again, not looking at the cover, not looking at the grade. Oh, this is Bone. Oh, so this book. So, Brendan, the other guy that does Whiskey and Weirdos, he can tell you a lot more about this book. Not that he could tell you a lot more about it. Well, he can. He could tell you a lot more about anything. But this story, I heard about it not particularly long ago, it was one of those things that people are like, oh, there's going to be a Netflix show, it's going to be great, this is that. And I kind of blew it off. It became available. It's one of those books that people were really, really seeking. You have like 8 different variants, the 8 different reprints. So the red cover, the red bone is the first print, and then you had different colored bones indicating what version number, reprint number it is. But it came available. I bought this one and the second one. Absolutely love the story. It is one of those stories that, like, when I first heard about it, I'm like, oh, it's going to be cartoon, it's going to be stupid. If they do it correctly, it would be fantastic. It's a fantastic story. It's really, really well done. But let's see what this came back. 9-2. Nice. Nice. Again, I haven't seen the notes for these. So, when it becomes like a 9, anything above like a 9, you really don't know what they saw wrong with it. I'll have to, you know, read the grader's notes, which CGC now gives for free, which is nice of them. But yeah, 9's fantastic for this book. Again, this is one of those books that if you've read, it's really good. It's one that I'm looking to get the rest of the series. The pricing is, let's just say, well over $100 per book. it's not cheap. But the story is fantastic. I love it. It's really, really, really well done. And I did not expect that to be the case. It's one of those things that, you know, you read the Keystone, not Keystone, I'm sorry, the Key Comic Collector, and you're like, oh yeah, they say it's a $1,000 book, there's no way. It was a low print run. It's a, what's the name of the production company? The production company is Cartoon Books. Not really. It's not Marvel, it's not DC, it's a small publishing company. So the print run is probably in the 90s, probably not huge. And of those, how many existed to that quality is probably even vastly, vastly limited. But like the story, it's really worth the read. Not saying you should read it online if you can't pay it, but you may want to read it online. Moving on. Next book. All right. Oh, shit. Let me pull off the bag that CGC throws on. This is Daredevil number 1. This is a book that I bought and kind of rebought. So I bought it from one of the shops in the area. I said, I don't know if I have the money for this. I want to buy another book. And then kind of sold it to one of my friends who also goes to the shop. And he's like, yeah, yeah. And we did a Venmo. And then I paid him back because I'm like, you know what? I want to keep it. I want to keep it. So this is coming back as a 3.5. So, respectable. I could see why 3.5. The cover looks fantastic, but it's all the smaller issues. So this one, the cover is pretty much detached for this section. There's a tear. So this staple really isn't doing much of anything. And the bottom section was pretty much detached. So the label's, the cover is basically hanging in by a thread, but it looks fantastic as far as like display. Yeah, I can't complain about that. There's no real big creases, no drawings, no huge issues with the cover. The back cover, same deal, very solid. A little off kilter. That's probably because if you see the pages kind of overlay over each other, that's probably because the book, you know, lost its cover. It's not restapled, but it probably just wear and tear, flat faced and smushed. So, but yeah, first Daredevil number one, 3.5. I'm actually 1964 for 3.5. That's not bad. I'm not mad about anything. I'm kind of upset about the Ninja Turtles, but I'm not mad about it. I understand. I kind of want to read the graders' notes to see what their thinking was. I'm not saying their thinking was wrong. I'm just thinking the grading was a little, I don't know. We'll see. This feels like it's sliding around in here. This was a big one for me. This is Marvel Spotlight 5. This is the first, what is his name? Ghost Rider. That's right. First Ghost Rider. This was a book I always wanted to get. It was available at one shop. I didn't move on it. I regretted not moving on it. The person got graded, came back great, and I regretted it. Another shop had it. The other shop that I've mentioned before had it. I went to that shop, able to buy it, and I'm very happy about this. This book, I mean, Ghost Rider was my childhood. You ride a bike, you jump off the bike, you call it ghost riding. It was just one of those things. This is coming back as a 9.2. Wow. 9.2. That is really, really, really good. So, okay. Wow. This may be the book that was the reason why my quoted price for CGC was a lot higher. Like I said before, when you go to CGC and you try to get your books graded, you go to a little kiosk, you tell them how much you think the book is worth, they give you a quote. 2 months later, or however many days later, they get the books, they decide, you know what, you graded it as under $1,000, we're going to grade it as something that's well worth over $1,000, which is what this would be. I think the fair market value right now for this is as a 9.2. Probably in the $8,000-$9,000 range. They will turn around and say, well, because it's over that $1,000 limit, we charge you 4% of fair market value to grade it. And that's probably why they charge me a lot more than I expected in general. But wow. Okay. 9.2. Wow. Okay. I did not expect that. I really expected it to be a little bit less than that. I'm pretty sure I expected it to just be a 9. If a 9. 9 was like the, oh my god, that's a 9? Or an 8.5. The difference between a 9.2 and a 9 really isn't much of anything. It's not much of anything. But the difference between an 8.5 and a 9 is more or less substantial. It's subjective going from a 9.2 to 9.4 to 9.6. I think CGC will tell you otherwise, but I haven't seen anything that was like a... I haven't seen a 9.4 and then a 9.6 and went, wow, there's a huge difference between those two. I don't think there is. CGC will tell you otherwise. It's also one of those things that maybe they got a whole bunch of books and 8 or 9 of them they're looking at, and then they see another and they're like, well, this isn't anywhere near like the 8 or 9, for better or worse, depending on, you know, the quality. And they kind of, it's not a sliding scale, but humans are looking at this. Just humans that may get tired, humans that may decide, I've seen enough of these that look better than the one I'm looking at right now. Who knows? But this is the last, this is not the right book. I pulled out the wrong book. I pulled out that again. I pulled out the Teenage Mutant Turtles again. So I'm putting that back. But I am going to pull out the last book. And the last book is a, I don't want to call it a grail, only because I don't like that term. The reason why I don't like that term is because, you know, a grail kind of, to me, suggests that once you get it, you don't need anything else. You're done. And that's not collecting in my head. Collecting, I don't feel you're ever really, really, really done. I just feel like you kind of, you get something where you're like, wow, this is amazing. And then either you move on to something else or you get a better version of it. It's collecting is an addiction. It's a sickness. But there are some books that are well out of price range, or ability or availability for anybody. And I all right, if you call this a grail, I would agree with you. But this is going to be the Amazing Fantasy 15, which is the first appearance of, what's his name? It's the first appearance of Spider-Man, that's right, it's Spider-Man. So this is Amazing Fantasy 15. I'm not going to lie about that. It's seen better days. It was created in 1964, I want to say. Don't quote me on this. We'll find out soon. But, you know, I mean, this is one of those books that you just do not come by. If you do, it's not cheap. This was not a cheap book in the slightest. And I had to get one of the custom labels because I had to go extra like that. It's $5. It's stupid. But I thought, you know, it's I wish it was the old, you know, I wish it kind of did the same Spider-Man, but apparently what CGC is doing is like these seasons of labels, so they'll retire this eventually, they'll get a new type of Spider-Man or new look of Spider-Man, which I'm not a huge fan of, but okay, keep it fresh, I get it, you know, not a problem. But this came back, this has to be very, very low, 0.5, yeah. So it says it's missing page 9. So page 9, I'm 90% sure is the page that, what's his name? Spider-Man. What's his actual name? Peter Parker. Well, Peter Parker finds out his uncle, what's his uncle's name? Ben, Uncle Ben, where he finds out Uncle Ben is, has been killed. I'm pretty sure that's what page 9 is. The interesting thing about that is the prior owner, I like to tell the story that the prior owner ripped that page out because it's too sad for his son. And because, you know, Uncle getting killed, like, it's not about, you know, nobody in comic books. In this comic book, well, I shouldn't say that because they do have murder mystery and crime mystery books in this. It's not just Spider-Man. It's Spider-Man and three other stories. But I like to think that somebody ripped that out because that is a sad story. I didn't get any of these books pressed. I'm pretty sure if I got them pressed, this may come back a little bit better, because you can see there's probably, there's a, like that crease right there. There's a crease right there. A bunch of creases down here. A bunch of creases here. But that still wouldn't take away from the fact that page 9 is missing. And the cover is well worn. It's hanging by literally an act of God, to tell you the truth. I think it's just old age is keeping it on. But yeah, 9.5 for this. I'm 9.5, geez. A 0.5. I am not mad about that, because again, how many of these do you see? Anyway, yeah, I'm very happy about this. I'm very happy about all of them. But this, however, this takes the cake. But yeah, this, that's it. I really don't think I have anything else to say. Yeah. Bye.